Hi viewers, welcome back to our channel Passionate About Physics. If you have not yet subscribed to this, please do subscribe it. In this present video lecture, I am explaining you the magnetic field due to a finite straight current carrying wire. How much magnetic field is produced due to finite straight current carrying wire? We knew that every current is a source of magnetic field. Every current carrying conductor will produce some amount of magnetic field in the space around it, which was discovered by Oersted. And in the previous video lecture of mine, I have also discussed Biot-Savart law, which helps us to find out the magnetic field due to a small current or length elements at a point P at a distance of small r from it. If you have not watched it, please do watch it. So if we recap that knowledge about Biot-Savart law, Biot-Savart law talks about the magnetic field produced by a small current or length element at a distance of small r from it. And the vector form of that magnetic field would be, because magnetic field is a vector quantity, it has both direction and magnitude. And the vector form of that magnetic field would be this, mu naught I by 4 pi dl cross r cap by r square. Or we can also write this in this way, mu naught I by 4 pi dl cross r bar by r cube, where r cap is a unit vector in the direction of dl to p. If you can see this picture, see this, r cap is a unit vector in this way from dl to p, and r cap is r bar by r. R bar and r cap are both are in the same direction, because r bar is nothing but r cap. R cap represents the direction of r bar, in fact, and small r is the magnitude of that separation, the vector, right? And if you write this expression in the scalar form, which is nothing but the magnitude of that magnetic field produced due to a small current element, that would be this, mu naught I by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. What is this theta? Theta is the angle between this length element dl and this r cap or r bar, whatever, because both are in the same direction. So this is the magnitude of the magnetic field produced by a small current element. This can be, this is Biot-Savart law, and we use this expression, we use this law to find out the magnetic field produced due to a finite length straight current carrying wire in this lecture. So see this picture. So AB is the current carrying wire of finite length, and we are going to find out the magnetic field due to this wire at this point P, and that point P is exactly at r distance, a perpendicular distance of r from the wire. And remember, if you consider the different points here, all these points are at the same perpendicular distance of r from this wire, but the magnetic field value at these points would be different for a finite current carrying wire. Even though the perpendicular distance of that point from the wire is same, but the magnetic field value is different, because if you consider this point, the distance small r would be different from length element dl, and the angle would be different, the theta would be different. If you consider this point, the distance small r would be different and angle theta would be different, because the magnitude is depending on that r and theta, but not that capital R in the case of finite straight current carrying wire. So then where do we specify this point? If each point is giving you the different magnetic field, where do we specify? For example, if I specify a point P here, and from that point P, there is some elevation theta 1 to this point A, where one end of the wire in this direction. And from the same point P, the elevation of the other end of the wire B would be theta 2. So when we are finding the magnetic field due to this entire wire, this theta 1 and theta 2 will helpful. And theta 1 and theta 2 will be different for different points of these. Right? So we use this expression from Biot-Savart law to find out the magnetic field at this point P. From due to a small element dl, current element or length element through which some current I is flowing. Remember, it is a steady current, time independent current, and at a distance of small r from the length element, P is located. So I am writing down this expression again because I am going to use it. The magnitude of the magnetic field produced at this point P due to this small element dl would be mu naught I by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. What is this? It is the magnitude of the magnetic field produced at this point P, which is at a distance of small r from a small length element dl. Right? So from that picture, if you observe, from this triangle, from here to here, if you see, the total angle should be 180 degrees for a triangle. Theta plus pi plus 90 should be equal to 180. Hence, theta will be equal to 90 minus pi. This theta, this will be equal to 90 minus pi. Right? And from the same triangle, what is tan pi, where pi is the angle between this r bar, separation between dl to p and the perpendicular distance, capital R. That is pi, and pi will be, if tan pi will be opposite side by adjacent side, that is L by R, which means what is L? It is R tan pi. L is equal to R tan pi. Now if you differentiate this, what is dl? It will be R is constant because it's a perpendicular distance, it will not change. R secant square pi d pi, because secant square is the differentiation for tan pi, secant square pi. And okay, from the same triangle, what would be the cos pi? Cos pi is nothing but adjacent side by hypotenuse. The adjacent side for this angle will be this, which is R by hypotenuse is R, small r. Okay? So this, from here I can say R is equal to R by cos pi. So we are going to substitute all these things, small r, dl and theta, in this expression. Now if you substitute them in the original expression, the magnitude of the magnetic field due to this element at point P would be
mu naught I by 4 pi. dl is r secant square pi d pi.
Sin theta is can be written with sin 90 minus pi.
By
r square is
capital R square by r square pi.
Then dB would be the magnitude would be mu naught I by 4 pi. Let us just simplify it. R secant square pi sin 90 minus pi is nothing but cos pi. D pi I am writing here. And cos square pi will go up. By r square. So if you see this, secant square pi is nothing but 1 by cos square pi. So this will cancel with this cos square. So what we get? Mu naught I by 4 pi. And this r will cancel with this square. So I am just taking it out. Cos pi d pi by r will get. This is the magnitude. Then if I want the total magnetic field due to this finite current carrying wire at this point P, then I should have to integrate this equation by using these limits theta 1 and theta 2. So then the total magnetic field, the magnitude would be integral dB, which is mu naught I by 4 pi cos pi by r d pi, and the integration should go from minus theta 2 to theta 1. You have to integrate from this this side to this side. So for example, if I have to start from here and end here, for this side it is the angle theta 2 and for this side it is the angle theta 1. And both are in the opposite direction. So that is why I am taking minus theta 2 here. And that theta 2 and theta 1 should be replaced for this pi. So minus theta 2 by theta 1, theta 2 to theta 1. Mu naught I by 4 pi is out of the integral. R is also out of the integral. Cos pi d pi. What is the integration for cos pi? It is sin pi with limits minus theta 2 to theta 1. If you substitute these limits, you will get mu naught I by 4 pi r sin theta 1 plus sin theta 2. This is the total magnetic field magnitude due to a finite current carrying wire at this point P. And theta 1 and theta 2 will be different for different positions of this point P. Then how do we predict the direction of this magnetic field produced at this point P? As I said in the previous video lecture when I was discussing Biot-Savart law,
you should have to use your right hand for the prediction of the magnetic field at this point P. So by keeping your thumb in the direction of the current and the fingers, wrap your fingers in such a way that the direction, the fingers direction is nothing but the magnetic field direction. So if you see, the point is this side of this wire, and this magnetic field at this point would be inwards. Magnetic field is inwards. So this is, we can also express in this way. For example, if this is a wire, if its current direction is this, and the magnetic field would be like, if it will be the B coming out and here it is going in, and if you take the current direction like this, then you have to use like this, and here it will be this, and here it is coming out, so it will be this. You can say dot here, cross here for this current, and for this current, this is dot and this is cross for the magnetic field. This is how we specify the direction of that magnetic field at this point P. And this is the magnitude of the magnetic field at this point P. Once you know the values of the perpendicular distance R and theta 1 and theta 2, you can get the magnetic field produced at this point. And one more important point here is, if the wire is not finite, because till now whatever the expression or whatever the direction we have mentioned for the magnetic field produced at this point P is for the finite current carrying wire. If current carrying wire is infinite in length, then what happens? If its wire is of infinite distance, what would be the change that we may observe? So for that, let me take down the equation for the finite first, again, which I have written here. The magnitude is mu naught I by 4 pi r sin theta 1 plus sin theta 2, right? This is for finite wire. Now, if the wire is infinite, what happens to this theta 1 and theta 2? If the wire is infinite, what is this theta 1? Theta 1 is the angle between this perpendicular distance and this line joining the end point of the point, end point of the wire and the point P. Now, if this A is away from this point P, because the length of the wire is infinite, and the approximate angle of this theta 1 would be this. Theta 1 would be this, which is equal to 90. Because A is somewhere away from this point. And similarly, because the wire is infinite, and this is also becoming 90. So theta 1 and theta 2 will be equal to 90 degrees for infinite current carrying wire. If that is the case, what would be the magnitude of the magnetic field produced at the point P for infinite straight current carrying wire? If you substitute them here, mu naught I by 4 pi r sin 90 plus sin 90, you will get 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2 mu naught I by 4 pi r into 1 plus 1, which is nothing but mu naught I by 2 2 pi r. This 2 cancels with this 4 and we will get 2 in the denominator. This is the magnitude of the magnetic field produced at the point P. If the length of the current carrying wire is infinite. Now if you see this expression, it does not contain any theta 1 and theta 2. We just have capital R in the denominator and small I in the numerator. Mu naught by 2 pi is anyway constant. I is also a constant current which is flowing through the wire. And R is the perpendicular distance from the point P. P for, to the wire, current carrying wire. And that is always same. R is always same, capital R. So in this case, what is the graph between magnetic field and the capital R, the perpendicular distance? That would be B proportional to 1 by R. You will get a rectangular hyperbola. If this is R, if this is B. As R increases, the B will decrease. R increases means what? The point P is away from the current carrying wire. The R increases, the B will decrease. And if P is very, very far away from the magnet current wire, then the B at that point may be a very, very small or zero. That means what? The magnetic field is existing only up to a certain distance around the wire. And if that point is away from the wire, at that point the magnetic field may be very, very small and it may be at zero. We can understand that from this picture. The graph between magnetic field and the perpendicular distance. And remember, for the direction of the magnetic field, in this case, should always can be predicted by using your right hand thumb, right hand rule. Thumb represents the current direction and your four fingers represents the magnetic field direction, like this. So hope you have understood. Thank you for watching this video.